This video is called Right Triangle Trig 1. And like I said, it's all going to start making sense now because we're going to go through some practice problems. The rest of your note sheet is simply practice problems where they'll be very similar to what you'll see on homework, four corners activities, quizzes, exams, review sheets, everything. So this is when we can put SOHCAHTOA to use. Why don't you start on the top of this side of your note sheet paper, please write SOHCAHTOA. Like I said, that should go on the top of everything for the rest of this chapter. Every sheet of paper, every note sheet, everything. Have SOHCAHTOA written somewhere accessible where you can see it. All right? So for this set of problems, we have a right triangle ABC where the side lengths are defined by an X, a Y, and a Z. And we are going to practice writing ratios requested using our sides. And remember, ratio means fraction. So for problem 8, it says write the ratio for the sine of angle A. So that means we're going to be going from the perspective from angle A. So let's just take a second. Let's label the hypotenuse. That's going to be the side opposite our right angle, where CB is opposite of angle A, and AC is adjacent to it. So I've labeled our side, so now the sine of A, remember, sine is opposite over hypotenuse. So opposite is X, hypotenuse is Z. So our ratio will be X over Z. Problem 9 wants the cosine of angle A. So we're still going from the perspective of angle A, but this time it's asking for the cosine. And cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse. So from A, Y is my adjacent, Z is my hypotenuse. So our ratio will be Y over Z. And lastly, the tangent of angle A. So we're still looking from the perspective of angle A, so my labels are still correct. The tangent is opposite over adjacent. It looks like opposite is X, adjacent is Y. So my ratio will be X over Y. The last three problems for this video are all looking from the perspective of angle B. The sine of B, the cosine of B, and the tangent of B. So notice I got rid of my labels because now we're going from a different perspective, so I have to label things differently. Well, maybe I kind of did a little too much. The hypotenuse stays the same no matter what perspective or what angle you're looking from. The hypotenuse is always that side opposite the 90 degree angle. But now the X has become my adjacent because it's touching angle B, where the Y is my opposite. So now it shouldn't be too bad to answer questions 11, 12, and 13. 11, the sine of B. So from the perspective of angle B, sine again is opposite over hypotenuse, so it is going to be Y over Z. We're the cosine of angle B, so looking from the perspective of this angle B right here, cosine, I look up at SOHCAHTOA, it says it is adjacent over hypotenuse. Adjacent over hypotenuse is X over Z. And lastly, the tangent of B, which is opposite over adjacent, looks like it's Y over X. So those are my ratios, and hopefully you're starting to see the importance or the helpfulness of SOHCAHTOA. You don't have to have anything memorized, but if you can have SOHCAHTOA memorized and written down, take the time to label the side lengths correctly based on what perspective you're looking from. In this case, it was A, and then it was angle B. You should be just fine.